welcome to the shop. This is just going to be a quick request video. I know I haven't done a video in a long time. I'm sorry about that. I should start doing it more frequently. But a viewer recently asked me in the comments of one of my videos if I can test a 1629 Magic Eye tube using my Precision Model 1012 tube tester here. So that's what I'm going to do today, because I think it's an interesting video topic to do, because last time I did a 6E5, which is a more common tube. The 1629 is also a Magic Eye tube. I have one right here that I pulled out of one of my pieces of test equipment, so I'm going to go ahead and test this one. I know this one to be very strong, so I'm going to run through the test procedure here and show you how to do it. So the first thing I need is a copy of the roll chart I have on my phone here. I pulled up a PDF version of the roll chart because this is a supplementary chart, because it's not on the one on the machine itself. So there's two tests. The first one is to test the actual triode section of the tube, and the second one is to actually test for brightness of the Magic Eye itself. So we're going to go ahead and run through the triode portion first. So here we go. So for triode, it says switch A needs to be set at 1, switch A to 1, switch 2, switch B needs to go to 2, okay? C is set to 25 on the C control, and D is going to be set to 10. And the filament voltage, let's see here. Let me find E here. The D control is 24, and the filament is on 10. I think that's right. Let me check this here. This doesn't seem... Yeah, E is 10. Okay, 1629. Yeah, E is 10. I just wasn't sure about that because that filament voltage seemed kind of high, but it might be a little bit higher than a regular 6-volt tube. Okay, so we've done that. So now the only thing we have to do is we can go ahead and put the tube in now, and we can test it for shorts. So I'm going to place the tube into the socket. It's an octal tube. The 16 or the 6E5 is actually a 6-pin tube. It's not an octal. So I'll get this warming up, and we're going to go ahead and check for shorts. So of course the standard shorts procedure applies. Pins 2 and 7 we don't need to test, because that's just the other side of the filament. We're going to watch our shorts lamp here, and we're going to go ahead and press each one of these buttons to observe, to test for shorts. So here we go, watching this light. Okay, there's no shorts. And the one other thing I wanted to mention with this tester, you don't want to flip up any of these levers until you do the shorts test, because I know it doesn't directly state that, but you do the shorts test with all of these levers down in the normal position. Okay, so with that being said, let's go ahead and set up our levers now into the correct positions to test the triode section of the tube. So starting out, levers W and X don't go to anything. Lever Y is going to go on 3. So Y to 3, or 3 to Y. Okay, and then lever Z is going to go to switch 5. So Z, or 5, is going to go to Z. Just like that. And now we're going to press the test button and observe the meter. And as you can see, I hope you can see that. Yeah, I think you can see that there. It's testing strong. So the triode section is good, and I know that. So now, the more important part is going to be the actual eye indicator test. So I'm going to go down one on our settings here, and I think I'll have to change a couple of the settings. So here we go for the actual eye test. So switch number 1 and 2 stay the same, A and B stay the same, C goes to 0, and D goes to 0. So those are both on 0, and now it says 3 and 4 are going to be up for the actual eye test. Now I think that's for the open and close, if I remember right. So switch 3. Let me see here. I think that's how you do it. Let me just check over the settings real quick here for the levers. Because it says, oh, I forgot. I think 3 and 4 have to be up. Yeah. So I don't know if you can see that, but our eye tube is lighting up. Let me get the camera a little bit closer. Can have a look at the actual eye tube itself. So I'm going to press the test button now. And our eye tube is lighting up. So I believe to actually check the shadow, I think you do like that. Yeah, is that open? Yeah, that's open. And I think to do... Yeah, okay. So open and close right there. So to do open, let's read the manual. So the manual for an eye test, it says that you set it up per the roll chart. After doing the short test, set all switches and levers as indicated on the roll chart to press the read meter button and observe the fluorescent screen, which should illuminate completely. We did that, and it does. So next, it says throw the first of the two levers indicated under the Y setting. And under the Y setting to the Z position. Okay, yeah. So it does what I said to do. So it says here's the two levers that are supposed to be up in the Y position, and we throw the first one down to the Z position, just like I did. And that will give us our first indicator, either open or close. So we check it here, and that's open. So then, to do the second section, or to check to see if it's closed, it says, a good tube will now exhibit the typical angular shadow. Return the same first lever to its original Y position and note closure of the shadow angle. And then during this, we disregard meter indications. So yeah, so you can see right now that it's open. Now it's closed. So that's all you do, is you just take the first lever as indicated, because it indicates on the chart here that 3 and 4, see if I can focus in on that, 3 and 4 right there should be thrown up to the Y position. And then when you do that, you set your levers down here. They're supposed to be like this, 3 and 4 to the Y position, and it glows fully closed. And then to test for an open shadow, all you do is flip this down like that into the Z position, and now it's going to be open. So you can see the difference as I'm flipping that. And you disregard the meter reading. So I hope that makes sense. That's all you have to do to test an eye tube on this tester, is you just have to set it up per the roll chart. So the supplement chart gives you the setup procedure for all your regular switches, and then you just read in the instruction manual what levers to flip in order to change the eye from open to close, and then you test the tube that way. And of course you disregard the meter reading. So that's all I have for you. I just wanted to show you that. Hopefully you'll find it useful and you'll understand how to test the eye tube. If anyone has any questions regarding this tester or how to test a magic eye tube, please let me know. If I didn't clarify anything properly or anything like that, I'll go back and do that. But I hope this answers your question.